السلام عليكم. هل الصوت عندكم واضح ولا لا؟
واضح
تمام.
واضح.
طب هو شوية في عندك كويزز كذا وسط المحاضرة، فإن شاء الله فيكون يعني انت تجاوب من الحضور ولا لا؟
الأغلب يرد على الشات.
تمام، كويس. Okay, so I know this is your last lecture for the day, يعني. But it will be about multiple sclerosis. I am Riham Youssef, fourth year medical student. And inshallah, today we will cover all of these objectives. We will talk briefly about myelin, then demyelinating diseases. Demyelinating disease is a big يعني, category, but the classical most common example is multiple sclerosis, so we will talk about it يعني mainly. So before I tell you what myelin is, can you tell me what does this picture represent? It's a neuron, so the neuron ممتاز. Axon. The neuron has cell body, dendrite, and an axon or nerve fiber. What is this red thing around the axon? This is myelin. ممتاز. Myelin. So myelin is a fatty substance that traps around the nerve fibers. It increases the communication or the nerve impulses between neurons. Or in other words, it allows rapid propagation of neural impulses. There is difference between the central nervous system and the VNS nervous system in regarding to the myelin. Can you tell me what does CNS stand for? Central nervous system, ممتاز. And the VNS. Peripheral nervous system. Well, myelin in the peripheral nerves is similar to the myelin in the CNS, but see some differences. مثلا في ال you know, في the peripheral nervous system, the myelin is made up by Schwann cells. A single Schwann cells will make up the myelin in one segment only. In the central nervous system, the myelin is made up by oligodendrocytes. A single oligodendrocyte will give up كده many processes. يعني it will make up myelin in multiple segments. Also, the lipids and the proteins is different in the myelin of the central nervous system and the myelin in the peripheral nervous system. Well, in multiple sclerosis, there is a destruction specifically for the CNS myelin. It will not involve the peripheral myelin. عشان كده في multiple sclerosis we will have CNS clinical features. Okay, now a quiz. What do you think happens when myelin get damaged? أول slide أنا تكلمت شوي عن الفانكشن of myelin. قلت إنه it allows rapid propagation of neural impulses. So if, ممتاز ممتاز. So actually in the 1980s, يعني researchers were interested in this. And they, one of the studies, they chemically induced myelin loss in the spinal cord of cats. So they found out that يعني signals will move very slowly and sometimes it will fail to make it till the end of the axon. عشان كده, if the myelin get damaged, nerve impulses, as you have said, will slow or even stop. And it will cause neurological problems. In other words, demyelinating diseases. So what is what are demyelinating diseases? The DE is a prefix meaning the loss or removal of. So in demyelinating diseases, there is damage to previously normal myelin. And this could be due to a lot of causes. Could be due to an autoimmune process or an infectious cause or due to a drug or a toxic agent. In this lecture, we are going to focus on multiple sclerosis and multiple sclerosis, there is damage to the myelin because of an autoimmune process. طب الحين بسألكم هل تعرفون إيش معنى autoimmune? When we say this disease is an when we say إنه هذا autoimmune disease, what do we mean by that?
When the immune system attacks itself.
ممتاز ممتاز. حلو أنتوا إذا عارفين autoimmune. So multiple sclerosis is an autoimmune. وصح تعريفكم the immune cell will attack itself. And it's demyelinating disorder. وحكينا إيش معنى demyelinating. Multiple sclerosis is also characterized by episodes of disease activity separated in time that produce white matter lesions that are separated in space. There are two keywords هنا مهمة. Separated in time and separated in space. Sometimes we call them dissemination in time and dissemination in space. في حاجة اسمها McDonald criteria for diagnosing multiple sclerosis. I'm not going to talk about it here, but I want to give you the concept of dissemination in time and dissemination in space. غالباً in multiple sclerosis, people or patients will have attacks followed by remissions. يعني they will be symptomatic for a few weeks, بعدين يتحسنوا أو تختفي symptoms ثم ترجع another attack. So هذا اللي يحصل في separation. In هذا example of separation or dissemination in time. بالنسبة للجزئية الثانية اللي هي separation in space or dissemination in space. احنا عارفين انه المصطبة سكروسيس فعادة فايدنس والله ممكن نعمل شيء كلي وثون إما لما الأجين نشوف الليز في كمان
الصوت يقطع شوي قطع الصوت
أعتذر منكم، الحين كنا واقفين على هذا السلايد صحيح؟ طيب، تكلمنا عن الـ dissemination in time. النقطة الثانية اللي بتكلم عنها اللي هي dissemination in space. احنا زي ما قلنا الـ multiple sclerosis is a CNS disease، ف we could have lesions in any part of the CNS، في الـ brainstem، في الـ spinal cord، في الـ white matter of the brain etc. فلابد نشوف لابد نحصل evidence إن والله في involvement of more than one part of the CNS. ممكن هالشي نعرفه في الـ MRI توضح لنا والله هذا الشيء، أو clinically يعني والله يجي البيشنت عنده impaired vision فمعناها الـ optic nerve is involved وعنده كمان weakness فمعناها أنه ممكن الـ spinal cord is involved. فهذا بالنسبة للـ dissemination in time and space. And since it's an autoimmune disease عشان كذا women are more affected than men. Okay, this is a pathology lecture, so we are going to talk about the pathogenesis of multiple sclerosis. As I've mentioned before, it's an autoimmune disease. The development of multiple sclerosis is related to genetic susceptibility and largely undefined environmental triggers. يعني genes and environment both play a role in the development of multiple sclerosis. There is no single gene يعني يسبب لك المالتيبل سكلروسيس. There is يعني multiple loci within different genes that make the patient or the person susceptible for multiple sclerosis. In your textbook it doesn't يعني talk about the environmental triggers of multiple sclerosis, بس vitamin D deficiency, smoking and obesity at an early age كل هذه environmental triggers for multiple sclerosis. Okay, continuing the pathogenesis of multiple sclerosis. This disease is initiated by T cells. And there is some evidence in حتى B cells and antibodies are also involved. إحنا لما نجيب agent, when we use agents that are targeting B lymphocytes, نلاحظ إنه هذه تحسن أو تساهم في علاج المرضى. جدا successful هذا الثيرابي، فلذلك هذا يشير انه البي سيلز والانتيبوديز حقتها تساهم في الباثوجينيسيس اوف ام اس، بس وي دونت نو اكزاكتلي هاو دو ذي بلاي ا رول، بس وي نو ذات ذي ار انفولد. سو تو سام اب، ديزيز از انيشيتد باي تي سيلز اند ذير از سم انفولد اند ذير از ان انفولفمنت اوف بي ليمفوسايتس، بس اتس نوت ريلي كلير كيف. So the pathogenesis of MS in a nutshell, it's an autoimmune demyelinating disease. Genes and environment play a role. Disease is initiated by autoreactive T cells. عشان autoreactive أقصد إنها autoimmune يعني process. So these T cells will call other immune cells and بعد كمان they will produce destructive products, تعمل destruction للمايلين. And there is unclear involvement of B lymphocytes. يعني هي involved but we don't know how. So now a quiz. أبغاكم تجاوبوا علي في الشات. True or false? T or F? أول statement. Only genes play a role in the development of multiple sclerosis. ممتاز. Genes and environment. صح. Multiple sclerosis is an autoimmune disease. True or false? ممتاز. ممتاز. Disease is initiated by autoreactive T cells. True or false? True, ممتاز. There is no involvement of B lymphocytes in MS. هذه الستيتمنت خاطئة. There is involvement, but we don't know بالضبط كيف. طب الحين هذا شوي في آخر ستيتمنت شوي advanced, بس خلينا نشوف. Anti-CD20 agents, for example, rituximab, are effective in preventing relapses in multiple sclerosis. What do you think? True or false? غير ريما، في أحد بيجاوب؟ You're correct, Rima. It's a true statement. CD20 هذه عبارة عن molecules on the surface of mature B lymphocytes. Rituximab is an agent that is targeting يمسك بهذا CD20 يمسك باللمفوسايت ويمنعها من أنها تدخل في pathogenesis of of multiple sclerosis. فعشان كده هي effective in preventing relapses في MS. واضحة النقطة هذه ولا لا؟ والفكرة بس أنا كنت يعني هذه السؤال فيه شوي immunology، إنه CD20 لابد تعرفون إنها عبارة عن antigen on the surface of B lymphocytes. If you know this, يعني you will be able to answer it. طيب. Okay, let's move on. Okay, morphology of MS. We know that in multiple sclerosis, there is loss of myelin. And myelin is wrapping around the nerve fibers. Where do we find nerve fibers? In the white matter or the gray matter? Mostly, يعني. ممتاز، white matter. عشان كذا multiple sclerosis is a white matter disease. And لما يكون عندنا lesions of demyelination, we call these lesions plaques. We can find these plaques يعني in multiple places around the ventricles, in the optic nerve, in the brainstem, in the spinal cord, in the cerebellum. زي ما قلت لك أي مكان في CNS. طيب. Can you see this gray in tan colored glassy appearance lesion around the lateral ventricle? هذه and multiple sclerosis plaque. And on the right picture, عندنا هذه we use a stain to stain myelin. You can see إنه في unstained regions. فهذه يعني يبين لك إنه in multiple sclerosis there is demyelination. طيب بالنسبة للبلاكس هذه قد تكون active or inactive. Active plaques will have a lot of white blood cells. So there is a lot of inflammation going there. But in inactive plaques, the inflammation will disappear. With white blood cells will be يعني little or ما في أساسا. Okay, now a quiz. What do we call multiple sclerosis characteristic lesions? Tangles, papules, plaque. ممتاز. إجابات في واحدة جاوبت أي إجابات أخرى؟ ممتاز. أوكي الحين خلصنا الباثولوجي part of this lecture. يعني إن شاء الله أنتم بسنة ثالث يعني الحين سنة رايحين سنة ثانية سنة ثالث راح تاخذوا lecture on demyelinating diseases. فراح تتعمقوا أكثر بالclinical features of these diseases. فI don't expect you صراحة أنكم تعرفوا التفاصيل مرة، بس أنا what I want you to know إنه تعرفوا how these patients are represented بس أو how they present. The symptoms can be variable depending on the location of the lesion. But most patients يعني they will have fatigue, headache يعني these general symptoms. But مثلا لو مثلا الليجن حصلناها في الأبتك نيرف we will have optic neuritis. So there will be impaired vision, color blindness, and it can be painful. Usually it's unilateral. And this optic neuritis is one of the, it's the earliest manifestation of multiple sclerosis. طيب إذا الليجن أو البلاك هذه موجودة في البرينستم ممكن الكرينيال نيرف يكون affected فيصير عندنا diplopia, trigeminalgia أو facial palsy أو internuclear ophthalmoplegia. أنا أتوقع هذه terms شوي جديدة عليكم بس يعني أشرحها سريعا ما I don't expect you صراحة to know them يعني بس مثلا في ال trigeminal neuralgia هنا the trigeminal nerve which gives sensation to the face will be affected فبيصير في عندك chronic pain للبيشنت في facial palsy بيصير في weakness of the facial muscles. وفي internuclear ophthalmoplegia هذا عبارة عن ocular movement disorder. لما يكون عندك black or lesion في medial longitudinal fasciculus, هذا الفاسيكولس very highly myelinated. لما يصير في ليجن هناك يصير عندنا هذا الديسوردر اللي هو internuclear ophthalmoplegia. يصير عندنا مشكلة في الادكشن للآي, ويصير بعدين كده كمان مشكلة في الconjugate gaze. ممكن تقروا عنه أكثر بعدين. طيب, now if the lesion is found in the spinal cord, ممكن يصير عندنا Lermit sign اللي هي زي electrical sensation كده that travels down the spine لما نعمل flexion of the neck زي هنا بالصورة هذه. كمان ممكن لو الليجن موجودة في الموتور تراكت يصير عندنا weakness. لو كانت الليجن موجودة في السنسوري تراكت يصير عندنا sensory issue زي numbness وtingling etc. ممكن أو لأنه كمان spinal cord يعني is involved in the autonomic reflexes, ممكن يصير عندنا إذا كان في lesion ممكن يصير عندنا autonomic dysfunction زي bowel and bladder disorders and impaired sexual function. طب if the cerebellum is involved ممكن يصير عندنا scanning of speech, nystagmus and intention tremor. Scanning of speech هذا عبارة عن dysarthria, يصير the spoken word will be broken down. وفي ويكون عندك long pauses كده between the syllables. وفي والنستاغمس عبارة عن involuntary repetitive movement of the eye. وintention tremors هذه عبارة عن tremors occur when you are trying to do something. فهذه كلها ممكن تصير إذا صار عندنا lesion في cerebellum. Also we can have multiple patients with multiple sclerosis can have changes in their mental status, depression, emotional changes, etc. أنا عارفة إنه هذا الكلام كثير, ما أدري إذا قدرتوا تستوعبوه زين, بس هذا summary أتمنى تركزوا الحين فيه. Multiple sclerosis is a CNS disease. عشان كده بيكون عندنا CNS symptoms. If the optic nerves is affected, we will have optic neuritis. If the brainstem is affected, we will have trigeminal, مثلا بنحصل trigeminal neuralgia, facial palsy, internuclear ophthalmoplegia. If the spine cord is affected, we can have muscle weakness, sensory issues, or autonomic dysfunction. If the cerebellum is infected, is affected, we can have this triad of scanning of speech, intention tremor, nystagmus. Another thing that I want you to know regarding the clinical features, أباكم تعرفوا the most common symptoms. Most patients will have fatigue, headache, depression, emotional changes, pain, bladder dysfunction, numbness, tingling, walking difficulties, and muscle spasms. تمام. بكذا نكون احنا غطينا الobjectives اللي وريتكم إياها في ثاني سلايد. بس أنا حاب أتكلم أكثر عن the clinical course of multiple sclerosis. We can divide multiple sclerosis into relapsing, remitting, secondary progressive, primary progressive, based on the clinical course of MS. فشوفوا معي هالصورة هذه. In relapsing, remitting MS, بيكون عندنا, أو خلي أشرح لكم أول شيء الجراف. شوفوا لاحظوا الجراف عندنا. في الإكس أكسس عندنا التايم. وفي الواي اكسس we have disability. In the relapsing remitting multiple sclerosis عندنا attacks كده, attacks followed by remission then another attack, so the patient will be symptomatic for a few weeks, then the symptom will go away or improve, then he will have another attack, then he will improve, then he will have another attack and he will improve. As a remission هنا could be complete as in this picture or partial, يعني في يكون شوية عندك residual disability, ما يكون complete remission, so the patient will have still some symptoms. Here the patient will be totally asymptomatic between the attacks. فهذا عبارة عن a relapsing remitting type. In the secondary progressive multiple sclerosis, the patient will start as relapsing remitting, then he will go progressive, يعني he will the symptoms will get continuously worse. But at the beginning, he كأنه relapsing remitting, but then he will go progressively worse. هذا بالنسبة للsecondary progressive. In the primary progressive type, the patient will be progressive from the beginning. So he will have continuous worsening of symptoms from the onset of the disease. واضح؟ تمام. طب الحين our final quiz. I want you to name the clinical course of multiple sclerosis. إيش هذا؟ Relapsing, remitting, primary progressive ولا secondary progressive؟ ممتاز رزان. ممتاز. Relapsing, remitting. ليش طيب؟ لأنه عندنا attacks followed by remissions. Attacks followed by remission. صح إنه هنا ممكن تلخبطتوا إنه هنا ال remission is not complete. ما هو تماماً asymptomatic. بس لا. يعني إحنا زي ما حكينا إنه ممكن يكون ال remission complete or partial remission. كل هذولا داخل ضمن ال relapsing remitting. This is correct. This is relapsing remitting type. طيب. يلا نشوف مين الحين يجاوب أسرع شيء على الصورة الثانية. Where is the clinical course here? ممتاز ممتاز. Secondary progressive. So عندنا هنا كأننا في relapsing limiting. Then the patient is getting continuously worse, كده progressive بعدين بالشكل. طب آخر صورة. ممتاز. Primary progressive. Primary. So the patient is يعني progressive from the beginning. These are the references that I used for this lecture. وإذا عندكم أي أسئلة أنا حاضرة ممكن تتواصلوا معي عن طريق الإيميل أي وقت.